This past year, no one can deny that athletes at Quinnipiac University have put in the work, and it has definitely paid off. From the men's hockey team to women's basketball, men's basketball, and women's rugby, Quinnipiac University is becoming more dominant within the college athletic spectrum. We're going to take you behind the scenes and into the locker room to see why Quinnipiac is doing so well. This is the Quinnipiac Bobcats, Seasons of Success.
Hello and welcome to Quinnipiac Bobcats Seasons of Success. I'm Zach Russo.
And I'm Tania Eicoff. Thank you so much for joining us. Over the course of the next half an hour, we're going to go over women's rugby's remarkable season and the importance of college intramural athletics.
But first, the Quinnipiac women's basketball team completed a dream season this past year, going 18-0 in the NEC. Katie Markley is with us with more on their fantastic year. Katie?
Thanks, Zach and Tania. I had the opportunity to catch up with a few coaches and players to reflect back on their record-breaking season and preview their bright future ahead.
I think that the Monmouth game that we played, the last game of 2012 season, really motivated us throughout the entire year. It was something we talked about every day, and that really was our fire for the entire 2013 season.
Those ladies worked so hard last summer in trying to get to the point where they wanted to be. They had their goals put out and they worked towards it all season.
They come in here and work every day. They're a competitive group of kids.
We know that when we come in here and we get our work done, that we're going to get better and we're going to do things that nobody thinks that we're going to be able to.
That included going on an impressive 20-0 run, earning themselves a spot in the NEC championship game.
We went into St. Francis PA game knowing that we were going to win because we knew that we could.
Pretty much we were just ready to go, ready to win. We wanted to win so badly.
But we all, you know, looked up at 11 minutes left in the second half and we were like, we are going to win this game. Like, there's no doubt in our mind.
It was an emotional moment because I was just really proud, of this group of kids and young ladies and all they had to do and all they accomplished.
Winning the NEC championship game in such dramatic fashion with over a 30-point victory was a relief. I personally was able just to exhale because that was what we needed to do to have that NCAA experience.
By capturing the NEC title, the Bobcats qualified for the NCAA tournament. The ladies traveled to Maryland where they would face off against the Terps in the first round.
I always see on TV like March Madness, like buzzer beaters. It was just cool to be there.
I've seen it on TV. I've seen girls play before me, and it was one of my biggest wishes ever to play in NCAA.
But seeing that many people at one time, like cheering, was crazy. Like, I get goosebumps talking about it now.
And the fact that we went into the NCAA tournament and competed so well on national TV against a great team in Maryland, could not be more proud of what we were able to accomplish this year.
Despite the 72-52 loss, the team's record-breaking season was the perfect conclusion to their final year in the NEC. Quinnipiac will break new ground when they join the MAC this fall.
The MAC conference is in the top half of all Division I NCAA conferences, so this is a major, major step for Quinnipiac.
Great basketball minds, great basketball conference, and it was really felt real and happy to be joining a tremendous conference that celebrates basketball.
I think it's going to be really tough. I think it's going to be a little bit better than the NEC. With Monmouth leaving and with Maris as the top, but I think we're going to be fine.
You're playing programs that have been around for 100 years, so they're rich in tradition, and it won't take very long for Quinnipiac to make its impact on that conference for sure.
A new conference brings new opponents, including a highly anticipated rivalry with top-seeded Maris. The Red Foxes have captured the conference title the last 8 straight seasons.
I hope that Maris views us as a rival, you know, down the road, because that's the team we want to beat. You know, that's the team at the top, and, you know, they've earned the right to have the target on their back, and we're going to come after them.
So I think that because we did so well this year that we're going to be good competition for them.
The change of conference combined with the national exposure from the NCAA tournament has helped to spread the quality of the Quinnipiac name.
The game in and of itself was so far-reaching that it was, a really big bump in terms of being visible I know that school's Quinnipiac and I know how to say it.
So it's pretty comforting now when I wear my t-shirts all over the country
they know who we are.
It's just showing that we're getting better, we're getting bigger, and people are now starting to know how to pronounce Quinnipiac.
The women's basketball team will face new challenges in the MAC next season, but the girls are hungry to return to the NCAA spotlight. Zach and Tanya?
Thanks, Katie. Coming up, we'll dive right in to find out how our teams keep winning. We'll be right back.
Hello and welcome back to Quinnipiac Bobcats Seasons of Success. You know, the Quinnipiac student athlete has a tremendous amount of competitive drive, as well as the much needed guidance and support of their coaching staff.
And this has been one of their most successful seasons yet. Dominic Lancella has found out some of the secrets behind their winning traditions.
Thanks, Tanya. The Bobcats were on fire last season, including an undefeated conference record for women's basketball and a trip to the national title game for men's hockey. The entire university has benefited from the most successful season since Quinnipiac joined Division I 15 years ago.
It all starts with the kids you bring in, the right fit. And Quinnipiac continues to bring in highly skilled and highly willed players that are really a success in the classroom.
You get a kid, an athlete on this campus, and they see how beautiful it is, all the facilities, the dorms, the education. I think it carries over to, you know, bringing good kids in who are good players.
Absolutely no doubt the administration. First, Dr. Leahy and Mark Thompson, who provide the leadership for our athletic department as a whole. Jack McDonald and Bill Mecca and the administration in the athletic department. And then the way they help lead our coaches and our staff.
I think that the growth of the athletic department and the success that we most recently had is directly related to the phenomenal growth of the university.
The success of our program allows the university again to gain that visibility. When you're on national TV, when you're calling your recruits, you're telling them, we strategically planned calling our recruits when we knew our hockey team was going to be playing on ESPN2.
Teams such as women's basketball and men's ice hockey have motivated other QU sports to build a winning tradition of their own.
They're already getting recruits that are showing interest in Quinnipiac for these unofficial visits this summer. So I think that the recruiting class for the 14-15 year will probably be the best we've ever had in all of our sports.
Potential student athletes want to go play for winners. You know, you add in the academics here, the level of academics and the reputation of the school, you add in a beautiful campus and a great community and certainly amazing facilities for the athletes to compete, it's going to be huge.
The university really does sell itself with how well it's really been recognized at a national level in terms of the U.S. News and World Report. All the programs that are offered here are, you know, second to none.
The recent success has gained Quinnipiac national recognition, which may translate to improved recruitment.
I think what it happens is it gives them the faith, the hope, and the belief that if one of our fellow programs have done this, we can do it too.
You know, women's rugby went to the Final Four. Women's acrobatics and tumbling went to the Final Two. Women's cross country won their eighth straight NEC championship. Men's soccer won the regular season championship. Everybody's sort of breathing success right now, and it's really helping all the teams. And I think the excitement from our students was second to none this past year.
Actually, going to the games, it's so exciting. The spirit is so high, and you just get so amped, and it's like so much fun. So I take great pride of being a student and a fan here.
And we see in six short years, just Quinnipiac athletics burst on a national scene. And then again, continue, and that's just going to continue and assure the academic success and branding and the visibility that the university will continue to have going further.
There's a lot of teams that our kids can pay attention to, be that in a pro venue, be that in a college venue. In order to get people to come to be part of something, you need to win. And when you win, everybody wants to be part of something that's successful.
As the Bobcats will try to build on their success, excitement and expectations will be at an all-time high next season. Tanya, Zach.
Thanks a lot, Dom. Coming up, we'll look into one athletic program that over a quarter of the undergraduates are involved in.
And we have another team on campus that has set the standard for achievement on the national stage. Stay with us.
Hello and welcome back. You know, Tanya, arguably the most dominating Bobcat team this past year has been the women's rugby team.
And with a final record of 15-1, the Bobcats set themselves up for a great postseason.
Jessica Boykin has the story.
Thanks, Tanya. After being established just 3 short years ago, the QU rugby team has gained national attention by making it to the semifinals this season. Losing just one game this year, these ladies are a force to be reckoned with. From very humble beginnings and recruiting players through flyers around campus, this team began to take shape for the fall of 2011.
A lot of people ask me, how do you recruit for rugby? And I say much in the same way all the other sports. We look for both rugby players and crossover athletes.
As long as you have those coordination skills and the athletic skills, the fundamentals of rugby, running, tackling, and passing can be taught pretty quickly.
We have a plethora of freshmen that we brought in that's included gymnasts, ice hockey players, basketball players, track runners, but then also had a little bit of rugby experience in there.
Well, my plans for college with gymnastics didn't fall through.
I came to Quinnipiac and kind of couldn't really find my niche when I first got here.
So I ended up just picking up rugby after high school, and it took me places I never thought it could.
And then they had tryouts for rugby, so I figured it would be a good opportunity, and I really fit perfectly in there, and I'm very glad I did it.
I think you're getting a lot of former athletes, not necessarily rugby players, but athletes throughout high school that have played other sports.
The talent was there with this squad full of ex-athletes. Now it was time for the coaches to do what they do best, make winners.
We knew as soon as we could steal Becky Carlson from USA Rugby that we were going to have a very good program real quick, and that's what happened.
And they said, you know, what are your plans? Where do you plan to be in 5 years? And where do you plan to be? What do you think that your team's going to look like? And I said, well, we should be somewhere top five in the nation, if not vying for a national championship within the second year. And it was then that I heard a few people laugh. So hopefully they believe us now.
The first preseason game, preseason practice this past August, we knew that it was going to be a special season. They know the game now, they came back fit, and we just kind of looked, me and Becky looked at each other, this may be a good season.
The coach's predictions were right. The team went on to be undefeated in the regular season.
Once we hit that 5-0 point, I think everybody on the team knew that we wouldn't take no for an answer. We went through all the games and we just knew we were going to win them. Then once we got to Nationals, I mean, we were pretty humble about it. You know, we didn't expect too much since it was our first time there. And I think we did extremely well for our first time around.
With this great season, the team found motivation in one word.
We had the word believe, and it was a word that we used throughout the whole season, and the team really took to that word. Believe in yourself, believe in what you can do, believe in what we're doing here at Quinnipiac.
The last motivation would come directly from the coaches before the national semifinal game.
Coach Reed and I got together before the game, and we said, maybe there's nothing we can say. They've done their work. They're here for a reason, and they've won enough games, and they've earned the right to be here, so maybe we don't say anything.
I like that type of coaching. Before you get on the field, there's no more they can possibly tell us. We worked as hard as we could to get to where we are, and there's just not much more they could say.
Before going into that game, we knew it was going to be a really tough game, but, you know, at that point, you kind of recognize how far you have made and how much you have to be proud of. Hearing her say that she was proud of us regardless kind of put us into the game with no pressure.
The Bobcats weren't able to pull off the win in the semifinals, but both the team and the coaches felt that this loss was necessary for the program to grow.
We needed that loss in a way to understand where we want to go next.
I think that since we went 14 games and winning them all, we didn't know what it was like to lose. Mm-hmm. And sometimes as a team, you need to know what that's like.
I think it's good for us because it kind of sets the bar for us and it gives us a benchmark that we want to beat.
One of the student athletes said to me after the game, it's okay, because it just gives us reason to come back and win.
Not a whole lot of people believed that we would be able to do this in the second season. So I think they trust each other, they play well together, and they work really, really hard.
I think that not only were we representing Quinnipiac, but we were representing female athletes, we were representing the student population. So I think that really motivated us to do well, and I think that we're just gonna continue on that path of success.
As you can see, Quinnipiac has dominated everyone in the NEC. We're eager to find out if the MAC conference is ready for this powerhouse. Guys?
Thanks a lot, Jess. Coming up next, we'll take a look into intramurals and see how all Quinnipiac students can get involved in sports. Stay tuned.
Welcome back. Not everyone may be an NCAA athlete. However, it doesn't mean you still can't play sports in college. For more on this, here's Brian.
Thanks, Zach and Tanya. Intramural sports are a big part of life here on campus. I wanted to know why, so I talked to some students and administrators.
Intramural sports are Quinnipiac students putting together teams and playing against other Quinnipiac students.
So what happens is you're able to put together a team with a group of your friends. You can hand pick who you want to be on your team, and then you can go about competition in the purest sense.
Thousands and thousands of Quinnipiac students, grad students, law students, and soon to be medical students come out and work the webs off, get the cobwebs out every afternoon playing softball and soccer and basketball.
It's like you come to Quinnipiac and now you already have like a set group close of friends that you made through playing intramurals.
We run sport leagues in about 19 different sports on campus. We allow students who played varsity in high school to be able to play in a competitive league against other Quinnipiac students.
Mike Medina and his staff do a phenomenal job, good facilities. The timing is correct because we try to schedule the intramural events when they're the fewest amount of classes and labs.
I suppose just besides the exercise, meeting people and trying to create friends, find friends, meet interesting people.
So they get the creativity of bringing up their own team name. They get the competition of playing 7 to 8 regular season games. And then at the end of the line, there's a championship t-shirt that's there and highly coveted here on campus.
While intramurals are a big part of campus life, they also play a role in the admissions process.
Usually when I go on the road, people ask me about sports, but a lot of kids that don't play a varsity sport ask me about intramural sports.
Intramurals is as much social as it is athletic. And when we meet with students who are interested in Quinnipiac, we tell them that they must, not should, but they must sign up for extracurricular activities.
We're starting to see from a collegiate trend perspective that a lot of students are picking their school not only based on the academic quality, but also the recreational opportunities that are available to them.
I would say it plays a good role in admissions numbers because a lot of schools don't have hockey, but not just hockey, all the other varsity sports are the intramural sports that are here.
Well, I think you always want to give students an opportunity to have outlets, and while the pressures of Quinnipiac academically can certainly weigh on a kid's shoulders, I think they need that outlet. They need that rec center. They need the fitness center.
Whether students are looking to make a championship run or just go out there and have a good time, intramurals offers something for everyone.
We see, you know, basically three different styles of students. You have the hardcore intramural athlete who basically tries to play every intramural sport that's possible.
I currently have 22 championships ranging from dodgeball, soccer, basketball, frisbee, and volleyball.
You have on the other spectrum the casual intramural athlete, someone who maybe knows someone in the dorms and are like, hey, you want to play on our team. They're not competitive, they just go out there to have a good time.
I have a set group of guys I play with for 5-on-5 intramural basketball, and we've been playing every year together, and every year it gets more competitive, we get more into it, it gets more teams, and we meet new people as we go along, so it works out.
And then there's the middle of the row, which is probably about 80% of our intramural athletes who played the sport in high school but don't have the opportunity to play at the varsity level here, just want to get out there once or twice a week for a good workout.
Goal to keep playing, yes, to obviously win, but also to stay in shape as much as possible and create the best team or teamwork.
I think it's just a great activity for the kids to do. They can do whatever they want here. There's so many different activities to do. Go ahead. You know, they're afraid to do this. Just go, do what you want to do. That's what it's here for.
So I think everybody really, really enjoys intramurals, and the numbers show it.
There's something for us to do where we can actually remember we're 18, 19, 20 years old, and life's about experiences and enjoying yourself. So I think intramurals gives you that opportunity.
Well, guys, from top to bottom, everyone at Quinnipiac loves intramural sports. Back to you.
Thanks, Brian. Well, that wraps it up here for Quinnipiac Bobcats Seasons of Success.
We hope you all learned a little bit more about Quinnipiac athletics than you already knew. For Tania Eicoff and the rest of our team, I'm Zach Russo. Thank you for watching.